The pineal gland lies deep within the brain. It's on the midline. Here is our pineal gland. It sits just below the corpus callosum and just above the midbrain. The pineal gland is not controlled by the hypothalamus and anterior pituitary gland like a lot of other endocrine glands are, but it does receive a lot of its main input from it's an endocrine loop. It's a neuroendocrine loop that begins with the retina. Light coming into the retina, going through the optic nerve, goes to a structure within the hypothalamus called the suprachiasmatic nucleus. Here is, of course, like our eye. So if we had retina here, and then optic nerve, which is, remember, is cranial nerve number 2, goes to the hypothalamus, which is this area, and it goes to a specific area of the hypothalamus called the suprachiasmatic nucleus, or SCN. The suprachiasmatic nucleus sends axons through the through the brainstem into the spinal cord, and it goes to the intermediolateral cell column, which, if you remember from the neuromooc, is where the preganglionic sympathetic neurons live. Okay? Those neurons then send axons out into the sympathetic chain, and specifically in this case to the superior cervical ganglion. And as you recall from autonomics, the superior cervical ganglion is the sympathetic outflow for the entire head and neck. The superior cervical ganglion then innervates the pineal gland and stimulates it to secrete melatonin. So to draw this all one more time, we go from retina through cranial nerve to the optic nerve, to the suprachiasmatic nucleus, from the suprachiasmatic nucleus to the intermediolateral cell column, IML, to the superior cervical ganglion, and then up to the pineal gland. Okay, so it's a loop. Retina, hypothalamus, spinal cord, sympathetic ganglia, back up to the pineal gland. Melatonin then is the secretory product of the pineal gland, and it is what coordinates, when it's secreted, it coordinates the rest of your body to control your circadian rhythms. So your circadian rhythms have to do with when your how your body knows it's day or night out. And it's not just that you can see light or not see light. Your whole rest of your body that isn't photosensitive has to know that it's day or night. And this is how it knows, by the secretion of melatonin. So the pineal gland not only helps entrain the rest of your body to day and night, it also is how you translate the length of day and night, so the seasons, into your body rhythms. Now, this is most important not so much for humans, but for seasonal breeders. So animals that breed in the spring or breed in the fall, the length of day and night is going to be it's going to be recorded or translated to the body through this loop. And then the secretion of melatonin has an influence on the secretion of gonadotropins, and that is what entrains the body for seasonal changes. So what do I want you to know about the pineal gland? What special sense regulates the pineal gland? And what are the different steps from that sensory input to the final innervation or stimulation of the pineal gland to create melatonin? Oh, and I just answered that one. What hormone is secreted by the pineal gland? And then what is its function? If you know all of these things, you're ready for the assessment.